You're on top of the world. You're in time, you'll be there.
Tandem, come the full-time whistle today. In hurling, the All-Ireland champions, two pretenders to the throne, going all out, of course, for an upset. With me in studio from the hurling side of the house, we have Tomás Mulcahy and Pete Finnerty. And looking after matters of a footballing nature, it's Pat Spillane. Now, speaking of football, let's look forward first to that Bank of Ireland-Leinster football clash between me.
Maybe raining cats and dogs in Croke Park. It's a perfectly fine and wonderful afternoon. Almost no breeze around here in Semple Stadium, and we're looking forward to a tremendous match in the Munster semi-final. There's already been an intermediate game between the same two counties. It finished level, 1-11 apiece. Liam Griffin is here with me, as you say. Well, now, this time last year, it was Cork who had the six newcomers. Today, it's Limerick with four and two other guys who are playing just their second championship match. It's a huge challenge.
It's a huge challenge for Limerick, and they're roughly about where Cork were about 3 years ago in terms of the development of a team. But it's a big and daunting ordeal for these young guys to go out here today. But Eamon Cregan is a great manager, and I'm sure he has them well fired up for the occasion.
All right. Well, now, a lot of people are focusing on the battle of Brian Corcoran, Hurler of the Year last year, tremendous player, as we all know, against Kieran Carey, who's probably in there to make sure that his influence isn't all that great. But what about Brian Begley, under-21 player, star hurler, footballer as well, against Diarmuid O'Sullivan? Key tie, I will thought.
Yeah, well, I mean, Brian Begley's had a very good league campaign and did extremely well against the likes of Clare and so forth. But today he faces the best fullback in Ireland by a long mile at this stage. So it's a very daunting task for him, but he's got height and size. And if they play him the right quality ball, he might get some good high ball in the air, but it's a tough task for him.
And in a word, who'll win?
Cork.
Okay, that's Liam Griffin's tip. We have two fantastic matches in the offing this afternoon. The two All-Ireland champions from last year putting their title on the lines, Michael.
You've started the defence of your All-Ireland title. Does it still feel as good as it did the day you won it?
Well, it's great to look back on it, certainly, and you know, it was a great occasion for all of us. It was a long road, a lot of bad days along the way to that, but certainly it was one of the highlights of the last number of years, as far as I was concerned, anyway.
Did you always want to return, though, to Limerick?
Well, as I said to you before, when I took Offaly in 93, I didn't think that Limerick and Offaly would meet in the final in 94. But I always wanted at some stage to come back to Limerick, because I had been manager in 88 and 87 and 88. And again, it was at a time when a team was going down, when I say at the end of their careers. I came back then to Limerick in 98, and something similar was happening. And now things have changed a little bit since then.
Well, I think Eamon Cregan is heading down the road that we did a couple of years ago, bringing in a lot of young players and building up the base from there. So they've obviously made great strides. They got to the league semi-final, and I'm sure they think that was certainly progress where they're concerned.
The Cork team is a very good team. They're All-Ireland champions. They've won the matches last year with conviction. They may be slightly confident, overconfident. I hope they're overconfident. And they're extremely good ball players. They have a very tight defence, good goalkeeper, and forwards are very nippy.
We use the games in the National League as a means to try out players, and I think it's fair to say that a number of players have been very, very impressive throughout the National League, and they're not starting today in the game. So we have a very strong panel of players now. And when we announced the team there right in Parker Keeve, there was a number of players, I'm sure, who were very, very disappointed not to be in the starting 15. But that proves the strength of your panel, I think, and I am very satisfied that we have a stronger panel than we had last year.
There are always players out there that are good in individual clubs, and what we try to do then is pick out those guys and try and draft them in. Now, we have seven under-21 players that are on a learning curve, and suddenly during the league, they suddenly clicked. Didn't the first match, but then from the Offaly match onwards, they began to play well, and we began to win matches. And a new air of confidence appeared in them. And when you look at young fellas today, and you look at the Munster team, and look at the young fellas there, they have the confidence of youth. And some people would say they have the arrogance of youth to come out and do things that others would not do.
In my time involved in coaching teams, certainly anyway, it's often been the player you least expect to play well on a day, or who's under most pressure in, who responds. The player you expect to play well might have an off day. So you just have to be aware of all what's going on around you and assess the situation and keep your wits about you.
The positive about this particular team is that all of the players are capable of scoring, and they all want to score. We played Kilkenny in a challenge match in Dunamagan about 2 weeks ago. 11 of the team scored. Now, they may have only scored 1 point or 2 points, but 11 of them scored. Before, you had only one or two players doing all the scoring. So, you know, they're all capable of scoring.
Being champions carries its own pressures, and yeah, it's up to all players now to prove that they can carry that mantle of favouritism and an expectation that has been, you know, raised since last year. And I think the public in Cork have a greater expectation now, obviously, and that brings its own pressures. But it's a great way to be going into the game as All-Ireland champions.
I hate the 2 weeks coming up to a match, because you're there and you know the match is coming, you know what can happen, you know what can go wrong, and it's a kind of a negative feeling, but you've got to overcome that. And once I get in with the lads, then things change. But you're always fearful, and again, that's, I suppose, old age. But young fellas are looking forward to it. I'm probably hoping that I'm hoping for their sake that their performance on the, and that's all we need from them, is a good performance from them, a winning performance, but they can do it, and I'm confident that they can do it.
We've worked very hard to prepare the players for the type of challenge we expect from Limerick. We expect a huge challenge. It's going to be, you know, a devil, you know, do or die attitude from them, and we're going in the same way. It's a huge game for both counties. The rewards are massive. You get to a Munster final, you're in the quarter final, you got earned at least. So the incentives are there for both teams to go and win the game. So it's going to be a huge test for us, and I can't wait really for it to start.
Well, nobody from the side that defeated Kilkenny by just a point last September to record the first championship win for Cork. It's up in North Cork, not too far away from Charleville. Wonderful little club ground up there. Great atmosphere always when you travel around that part of the world to enjoy a game of hurling. Sean O'Gohalpine there at the back, and the crowds everywhere and anywhere, I would say. We're talking in terms of 35,000, maybe even a little more, here at Semple Stadium this afternoon. The traditional photograph then, but a tense occasion. Check on the teams. Joe Quaid is back in goal for the Shannon Siders for his seventh championship campaign. Stephen Lucy gets the first championship opportunity in a slightly revamped backline, minus team captain Clem Smith. Brian Geary now operates at wing back, while there's another Munster debut in midfield alongside James Moran for Mike O'Brien. Kieran Carey, a hero and a warrior many times in the past, is selected on the 40 for Eamon Cregan's team, having been largely absent for the past year or so. He takes his place in an attack that shows two freshmen to championship activity, Mark Keane on the left wing and James Butler in the right corner. Limerick, with 11 of the players who lined out last year against Waterford, beaten by just a point in round one of the Guinness Munster Hurling Championship. Joe Quaid in the centre. Oh, well, Cork's backline is the same as that which won the All-Ireland last September. John Brown is back, having missed the first round game over Kerry. Brian Corcoran was last year's Hurler of the Year. Today he's flanked by Wayne Sherlock and Sean O'Gohalpine. Injury prevents last year's captain Mark Landers from starting in midfield. So it's the East Cork duo of Mickey O'Connell and Pat Ryan once again this week. Well, as it was last year once again, it's this for this Munster semi-final, it's Ben O'Connor, who missed the first round exercise against Kerry, but he's fit and resumes at left corner forward. Four of these forwards, I think, could be slotted into any of the six positions for the record.
They're well managed this year by Eamon Cregan. He's worked very hard at bringing on new and sparingly adding in some of the older, more experienced players. Two players to watch for, in my opinion, will be Ollie Moore at number six, who's the captain, and number 12, Mark Kenny, who is a newcomer. And Limerick under Eamon Cregan should not lack determination and passion.
What about the... well, there's Eamon Cregan there. He's hoping that they play a very, very fast style of hurling.
Sullivan, I think all of us in hurling know that Dermot O'Sullivan is a special talent. And their full forward line of Shawny McGrath, Joe Dean and Ben O'Connor nowadays, to be quite honest, in the full forward line.
The crowd swelling the whole time, and Jimmy Barry Murphy real team there.
Yeah, Sean O'Gohalpine, I think, is a very special man. I think he represents everything that's best about Irish manhood at the moment. He's a new breed of an Irish man. His mother is from Fiji. They're very proud of their Fijian heritage and of their Irish heritage. I actually said to Micheál Mórahertig before the game, he's the Satanta of Irish manhood at this stage.
You
and
know
I understand
he's a brother
called Satanta.
Satanta
as well. Yeah. So I had it slightly wrong.
But
he's a great man and a great role model for young people.
Well, two people watching this are Paddy Hunt in the regional hospital in Limerick. He's from Tulla. Evener from Dublin is in charge. There's going to be a minute's silence, as I understand it, before all of this can get underway. Minute silence intended to honour the memory of Eddie Stokes, brother of Nick and Dick from Palace Green, and of course a former Limerick and Munster Railway Cup player. So the details being given to the crowd here. Straight away, it's Limerick who are pushing forward here, start of the match. Dermot O'Sullivan back defending. And that's going to be a free out to Cork. An altercation straight away there with Brian Begley. Referee calling across the big full forward. Barry Foley's down injured. It was heated, it was expected to be so.
In fact, in fairness, I think Dermot O'Sullivan pulled back towards Brian Begley, and then I think there was a retaliation came in afterwards, Joe.
We may get a chance to look at that again. Brian Begley is spoken to by Eardon Maxivna, and it's the first yellow card. Only about, 50 seconds gone. That happened after about 20 seconds. Still a couple of players down receiving attention. Barry Foley's down, so too is Dermot O'Sullivan, and this is what happened just moments ago here. Little clash of legs. And then watch for Begley and O'Sullivan. Both men back on their feet again.
This is not good, Joe. We don't need to see this at the start of a hurling match. Intensity is required, but not like that. It's no, absolutely, totally unnecessary.
It's ridiculous. So referee also taking out the yellow card for Dermot O'Sullivan. Referee is putting down a marker, I think. Any more of this, and the next guy is in trouble. He's going to throw the ball in rather than the water free. Cork with it. And there's a high challenge there. And the player taking it out was Wayne Sherlock. And the Black Rock man was fouled, and it's a free to Cork. But it's an unpleasant and unhealthy start to the game.
Well, in fairness, Gerard, the lads are a little bit pent up and a little bit hot. I think it'll sort itself out very quickly.
That's in towards the corner. Steve McDonough. Pat Ryan trying to pick it up, taken instead by Ben O'Connor. Still going forward is Timmy McCarthy. Neil Ronan. Ronan trying to step away from danger and trying to put over the first point of the match, but he's put him wide instead. There was plenty of pressure on him there. Mark Foley from Adair was over-challenging. Joe Quaid here. Directed into the Sean O'Halfine's corner. Limerick looking for the first point of the match. Instead it's Brian Corcoran. Challenged by Shane O'Neill. And the foul, and it's going to be a free to Cork once more. Too many frees already in the game. There's Pat Ryan, who is the Mickey O'Connell about to take over here. Free taking duty. Mickey from Middleton, as Shane O'Neill has his number recorded by the referee. One more foul and he would be getting a yellow. O'Connell. TJ Ryan's in there trying to clear this ball out, and it's taken away very effectively. Great play over there by Mike O'Brien. Left behind by Brian Geary. Mark Foley trying to get the ball out. Neil Roman trying to come in to take it. Looking for the opening point, and he gets it. Neil Ronan from Ballyhay. made a mark contribution last year when he was only 19 years of age, and today he's got the opening point of the match after about 4 minutes play. Change of direction of the puck out this time by Joe Quaid. Kieran Carey coming to try and meet it. Mickey O'Connell nipping in, the midfielder. Sending it up towards Ben O'Connor. Stephen McDonough's there as well. TJ Ryan came out, committed himself, didn't take it however. Brian Geary used to play in the corner, now out at wing back this afternoon. Ryan once again. It spills loose. Joe Dean trying to hand pass it outside to O'Connor. He's fouled. A chop down foul, and the referee is no more than a couple of yards from the action at all times. And he really is laying down the law. He's awarded quite a number of frees against Limerick, and the match is only 5 minutes old.
Yes, I mean, Limerick are obviously anxious to go out and perform against the All-Ireland champions, but are a little bit too hasty, and their control is letting them down slightly at this point in time, and they'll pay dearly for this with free-taking of this quality that you're going to see in a moment.
The free-taker will be Joe Dean from Killa. Joe playing in his 10th championship match. Made his debut against Limerick, and he's put that one over the bar. So it's a second point for Cork, the All-Ireland, the Munster and All-Ireland champions. The stage of the game now where Limerick just need to settle down, get their rhythm going, get that speed into their game that they're well capable of doing, and put it up to the champions. Here comes Kieran Carey, ever a member for that magnificent point he scored against Clare down in the Gaelic grounds, 96 that year. Here is into James Butler, and Butler has put it left. Well aware, even though today is just his debut, that you get just that amount of space, that amount of time to get your shot in.
He's an exciting player, young Butler. He's played very well through the league. A little bit overexcited the last day in the league semi-final, but he has the makings of a fine hurler, and this stage will do him no harm whatsoever.
That semi-final, of course, was here against Tipperary. So they have the experience of playing there. James Moran firing it back in again. Taken down here by Butler once more. Second shot of the target, perhaps. No, inside, and put over the bar by Brian Begley. Begley from Mungret. His first point. Well, he's had an eventful opening 7 minutes of the game. Already had his name taken. Now he scored Limerick's first point. It was a lovely pass from Butler to Begley to make it all happen. And Limerick, I notice, already warming up. Dave Stapleton. Meanwhile, Fergal McCormack driving that one in towards Shawnee McGrath. Racing after him over there is Stephen Lucy. McGrath. It gives a chance there to Mark Foley to get this one out. Remember his fantastic performance down in Porky Cueve in 96. The day that Limerick absolutely trounced Cork. Mickey O'Connell inside towards Shawnee McGrath. Some holding. Free in. The holding is done by Stephen Lucy. Stephen, who was the centre half back on the under 21 football team, and of course son of Mick Lucy, the former rugby international.
Ger, Limerick don't need to do this. I mean, they're going to be punished severely for this. They have to keep their discipline in hurling. If you give away too many frees like that, they're soft targets, they're soft scores, they're hard earned in regular play, so it's dangerous policy to pursue.
You can't give away chances, as you say, against Joe Dean, a mere 30 metres out when he struck that one. Let's have a look at the skill of this just moments ago here. Mark Foley was involved. Whoops, taking it away there from Timmy McCarthy, then getting it back onto the stick. Great clearance. Mike O'Brien in there challenging. Nice hand pass outside. Barry Foley. Great one by Barry Foley. They need a score. He can't provide it. Well, Barry Foley still remembered for the 4 points he scored in the 96 All-Ireland final, all in the first half, but substituted in the second. How fortunes can change. That's now a second wide for Limerick. Donal O'Cusack from Cloyne about to puck this one out. Timmy McCarthy trying to race into the clear. Chasing after him is Brian Geary. Geary still gives chase. McCarthy is bottled up successfully. Quaid is out. Ball goes wide. It was a close call.
This is Timmy McCarthy's kind of stock and trade. He gets the ball and runs at the fences. Last year in the Munster final, didn't do very well. All-Ireland final did very well, but he's a strong carrier of the ball.
I think he got 3 points in the All-Ireland final. I think he did really well that particular day. Still remembered, of course, for a great goal he got at under 21 level against Tipperary a few years ago. Won the match for them. Mike O'Brien rises up for it. Pat Ryan's there as well. Fired long, down, into the corner. James Butler. He had just enough time, but he never really threatened Donal O'Cusack. Good change of direction. Solid goalkeeping. Up towards Neil Ronan. McCormack's there as well. Nicely balanced by Brian Geary for Limerick. Stopped by Ben O'Connor. Pressure there. And the man in the corner is Stephen Lucy. Comes out towards Mark Foley. Another fine, lengthy clearance by Foley. Sean O'Gohalpin going in there to deny Shane O'Neill. Coming on to James Butler once again. He's had a few chances. He's missed one. He's made another. He's scored his first of the game.
Sure, this should settle this young man down, because he really is a promising hurler, and that's exactly what he needs in a championship match, to get off his mark early, and that's an excellent point. He's playing very well.
This was the pressure that was exerted there on Sean O'Gohalpin, and when it came to Butler, off his left-hand side, he struck it magnificently. Puck out by Cusack. Fergal McCormack drifts towards the left again, gets there ahead of Ollie Moran. He's trying to open up a gap there at that half-forward line. McCormack still. Kicking, stopped by Quaid. Out to DJ Ryan, difficulty with his first touch. Still trying to get it away from Ben O'Connor. Lots of pressure. Beyond James Moran, picked up here by O'Halpin. Shane O'Neill's after him. Effective shoulder, but it still comes back towards Pat Ryan for Cork. The All-Ireland champions looking to force another one, but they failed to get it. And it's still 3 points to two.
Jared, just on Sean O'Gohalpin, I think people who might follow other sports like rugby.
This was McCormack just a moment ago here, Liam, as he was coming through all the way, almost Timmy McCarthy fashion, kicked, saved by Joe Quaid. What you were saying?
Yes, but Sean O'Gohalpin, if you watch rugby, the Samoans are great runners of the ball, and he has the footwork of a Samoan, and it really is special to watch when he gets in flight with the ball.
And of course, he spent his early years in Fiji. Brian Corcoran spent his early years down learning his trade in East Cork. Trade as a hurler, that is. Here comes another East Cork man, Mickey O'Connell. Hand passing it out as far as Neil Ronan. Pressure there on Stephen Lucy, and they come in, and McGrath's got it, and McGrath's got the opening goal of the match. Shawnee McGrath, after 12 minutes. It should have been cleared. It really should have been cleared. But McGrath was there to pick up the pieces. Neil Ronan lobbing it in here. The pressure was all on Stephen Lucy going backwards. McGrath got the first touch and beat Joe Quaid. And the opening goal of this game comes after 12 minutes of play. Good work by McGrath. A really pacey corner forward, good predator. Always alert to the possible chance that might come his way. Very often only a half chance. Frank Murphy there in the centre of that Cork bench. County Board Secretary, of course. All the way down along. It's a strong Cork bench. Here comes Kieran Carey. Can he lift Limerick? They need a score. And he's got it. Ever the man for the big occasion. Kieran Carey from Patrick's Well. And that's a quick response, so just a goal in it. Well, this is where that ball was scooped in there brilliantly by Shawnee McGrath, wrong-footing Stephen Lucy. Ollie Moran coming out with it, it's dropped down once again, there's a gap. Over-commitment by the half-backs, it's Timmy McCarthy, that's enough. A first for McCarthy from Castle Lyons. And Cork respond once again to that Kieran Carey point. And once again they enjoy a 4-point lead. But this is his stock in trade, running at defences, shortening the grip, getting enough space. This is knocked on there towards Barry Foley. Brian Corcoran, good vision, back to Dermot O'Sullivan. Quick, rapid delivery, back up towards full forward. Comes out towards Shane O'Neill. Kieran Carey getting there ahead of his man, and it's Sean O'Gohalpin who was anticipating. Beat James Butler to it. Batted out by Mark Foley. He's playing well at left half back. Driven down by James, by Mike O'Brien. Inside towards Brian Begley. And again, it's Wayne Sherlock here. Coming out with it. Timmy McCarthy unable to keep the ball in play.
That was a free, Ger. I mean, there's no question about that. The crowd are incensed by that, and Limerick have been giving away a lot of frees, but they earned one there, which they should have had.
This is it again here. Well, that was the interception by Sean O'Gohalpin. Up and just before that incident. Oof, that could have ended up on the back of the net. It's gone for a 65. Corner back and goalkeeper were going for the same ball. Doesn't look completely at ease in spite of that Shawny McGrath goal. There's John Brown there. He's up against James Butler. So what can they make of this 65 struck by Mark Keane? And he's put it over. His first free of the match. Great play by the South Liberties man. I think Limerick will feel if they can stay nice and tight to Cork for three quarters of this match, anything could happen.
A very good duel in prospect here at the moment between Timmy McCarthy and Mark Foley, one of the best half-backs in the country at the moment.
Brian Geary is beaten for it. Falls down to Fergal McCormack, lashing it in towards Joe Dean, getting out there ahead of his man, TJ Ryan. Ben O'Connor's in, Ryan's coming out with it. Great play by the fullback. Plays at half-back with his club. News play off on the forwards for Limerick, of course, at senior level. Dropped back in by Shane O'Neill once again, opening it out there towards Barry Foley. Coming out first time is Fergal Ryan, Cork's captain this year. Wayne Sherlock, partially blocked. Still got a lot on it. In towards the goal scorer, Shawny McGrath. Beating Lucy to it, and he has put it wide.
Ger, Fergal Ryan is one of the tightest markers in the game. He's been improving over the years steadily, and it's very hard for Barry Foley to make headway on Fergal. He's a very, very tight cornerback.
Joe Quay today playing in his 17th championship match. Great catch by Mike O'Brien. Back it comes towards his midfield ally there, James Moran. Lobbed in towards Brian Begley. Begley, can he make something up? But he quite can't in the end. He hit it instinctively. He's put an awful lot of sport this year. Of course, star full forward as well with the under-21 team that went all the way as far as the All-Ireland final. Jimmy Hartigan there in the background. Michael Fitzgerald as well. Eamon Cregan here, the team manager. Donal O'Cusack. Again, Fergal McCormack goes for the puck out towards the left-hand side. They're all landing down in that direction. Here's O'Halpin, taking it away from Mike O'Brien. And once again, it's Mark Foley. I think he loves playing against Cork. Rises his game every time when he faces the blood and bandages, that they call him. Brian Corcoran, a little hesitant there, comes back out. Wayne Sherlock dropping it down, stopped over there by Mark Foley. It runs on, however, for Shawny McGrath. Trying to go by Stephen Lucy from Croom. Oh, he's got the legs on Lucy here, it seems. And he has found the target. A goal and a point now for Shawny McGrath. And the Glen Rovers man is having a field day.
This is tough for Stephen Lucy. He's on a really on fire Shawny McGrath, who's bringing him out the field and creating a lot of space in which to play and give himself room to score.
Lucy's club have done well recently. They've just won the Limerick All-County Division 2 League, trained by former team boss Tom Ryan, for whom Joe Quaid here made his championship debut against Cork back in 1994, I seem to remember. Here's Sean O'Gohalty. Challenge chased by Shane O'Neill. Ollie Moran lets it run in after. McGrath's out there. Lucy had enough time this particular occasion, but still doesn't get it away. It's Ben O'Connor going by. TJ Ryan trying to stop him, and Ben O'Connor fires it over the bar. His first point.
You know, Ger, Stephen Lucy is in serious trouble now. He's hanging his head slightly as well. You know, you can see by him his confidence is down. It's not easy for him at the moment.
Well, it wouldn't surprise me if changes were about to be made by Limerick, because they are certainly under pressure, certainly in that full back line. And there was Ben O'Connor beating TJ Ryan. And it looks now as though we are indeed about to have a change, and Clem Smith is about to come into the Limerick defence, almost certainly.
Clem Smith played excellently in the league semi-final, had a great game in the second half. He should be an addition to Limerick if his injury is not running him up.
This is the big question. He has this injury. He wasn't fit enough to start. Will they now bring him in after just about 20 minutes play? That's in towards Shawnee McGrath. Mickey O'Connor coming to it. Over the legs there of Mark Foley. Nothing intentional. Mark says there was a dive, but it certainly wasn't intentional in my view. Clem Smith is in.
A strong, powerful hurler on his day, and he should make a difference, but it's a bit risky with a guy that heavily strapped going into this serious championship hurling.
So the player who is about to make way is Stephen Lucy. Just didn't go well for him today. Brian Geary has gone back into the corner. Free has been taken, by the way, by Joe Dean. As we were noting the substitution, he's put that over the bar. It's his third point of the match. So Cork holding the advantage after just over 21 minutes play. Limerick needing something special now. Brian Corcoran has discarded the black helmet, thundering down the field. Hand pass outside here. Ooh, Mickey O'Connor went down under the weight of the challenge. Mark Foley again protesting. That's twice he's been caught now in the last 30 seconds. Nothing really malicious, but it's going to be a free once again to the Munster champions. O'Connell to take this. Scored 8 points against Waterford in last year's semi-final of the Munster championship. And Limerick are about to make a second substitution. Dave Stapleton is about to come in. That's dropping a little short. It's also dropping left. They do their best to keep it in play, but not effectively so. So there is Dave Stapleton. Jimmy Hartigan, the county secretary, giving him a little slip of paper. So Limerick using up two of their possible five substitutions before the 23rd minute has been reached, and Barry Foley is going off. Well, how fortunes can change. Nephew of Sean Foley, of course, played in the 1973 All-Ireland semi-final. That's the first substitution, but I tell you, as the game goes on, there'll be many, many more. It's going to be a Limerick sideline ball. They need something special. Dave Stapleton has gone in as a direct replacement for Barry Foley at top of the left. Meanwhile, it's Sean O'Gohalty. Great athleticism. Terrific sportsman. Bottled up well in there. That's very good play by Limerick. And James Moran combined really well there with a colleague to make sure that Sean Ogg wasn't going anywhere in a hurry. In the end, a free to the Shannon Siders. This is the first free of the match to Limerick. Nearly 24 minutes gone. This is in towards Begley. He got the stick to it as well. It would have been a great point, good old-fashioned type of hitting it over the head stuff.
It's noticeable that, you know, when the high balls come in, Dermot O'Sullivan is lining himself up directly behind Brian Begley because he expects him to catch and he's going to bat. He's obviously made this out, that's the way he's going to play him. You put your hand up, I'm going to bat it, and that's the way it's going to be.
Donal O'Cusack firing it straight down the centre towards Neil Ronan.
Early pull.
An early pull, yes, it's going to be a free. Foul on Clem Smith. Free to Limerick. So just to repeat that little statistic we gave you about 30 seconds ago, this is their second free. It's taken by Ollie Moran. Down towards Begley. Brian Corcoran was going for it, missed it. Still they pressurise. James Butler's in there against Fergal Ryan. Wayne Sherlock trying to keep it away from Begley. John Brown running into James Butler. Outside towards Brian Corcoran. And he wallops it away downfield. Back in there once again by a very determined Mark Foley. Lovely pick up here by Mark Keane. Out towards Mike O'Brien. Can O'Brien put this over the bar? They look at it. And he gets it. Mike O'Brien from Glenroe.
You'd have to say the Limerick midfield are on top. They've had three or four very fine high catches. And they're doing very well at midfield.
Well, this was one of Cork's problems last year, trying to get on top time and again in the midfield zone. It was a problem area for Jimmy Barry Murphy because he had a very, very good defence. Fergal McCormack against Ollie Moran. Drops loose. Hit away by James Moran. Nicely caught here by James Butler. Chasing after him is John Brown. Great block down by John Brown. Gets it away to Timmy McCarthy. Mark Foley is in there to challenge. And Mark ties him up a little bit over there. But Cork still get the sideline ball. 9 minutes to the break. So Cork with a 5-point lead. Mickey O'Connell to take this. TJ Ryan hesitated somewhat. Neil Ronan trying to get that ball up. They wait for it to come out. Clem Smith's around. James Moran trying to direct it away. Still pressure on the Limerick defence. Forward by McCormack. He clashes with Clem Smith. Stephen McDonough gets that ball away. Brian Corcoran, lovely catch. And a great block down by Kieran Carey. That is superb skill. It'll be a sideline ball to Cork. 10 out of 10 for Carey.
It's a lesson for young hurlers, Joe. You never give up. You can always get a block down on your player. If he wins the ball, you've got a great chance still to get a block down with your stick.
Two brilliant hurlers in action. Peak of their form. O'Halpin. He gets a really good connection. But Clem Smith's back there. Nobody's challenging. Comes back out towards Mark Foley. Delivers it once again in typical fashion down to the inside forward. Do something with it, he seems to be telling them. David O'Sullivan's in there trying to deny. The substitute has come in, Dave Stapleton, and Cork get it away. McCormack against Clem Smith, runs on towards Stephen McCarthy. Great work back there in the corner. Stephen McDonough. Geary did really well just to hold up the red tide, as it were. Two Limerick sticks going for the same ball. Breaks out to Neil Roman, crossing the 65-metre line. In towards Ben O'Connor. Pat Ryan was available as well. He's just ahead. Here he is. Challenged by James Moran. Gets the shot in. He's put it wide. That is six wides now by Cork.
Gerard, the Cork full back line is really dominant in there, and Limerick are finding it very hard to break them down. And that's probably one of the main reasons why Limerick are not making a bigger headway on it.
I see Dave Punch down on the sideline here, urging the Limerick team on. Pressure on Wayne Sherlock. Dave Stapleton, hands and knees job. Mickey O'Connell tripped. Stapleton, the guilty party, free to Cork. Mickey O'Connell, deep intake of breath. Playing today in his sixth championship match. This free is just inside Cork's 65-metre line. There's little or no breeze around. TJ Ryan coming out, gathering. Great play. Good clearance. Brad Corcoran against Kieran Carey. What catch again! Great hand pass, wonderful vision by Corcoran. We're seeing some wonderful performances all around the field. And that was a foul there on James Moran. It's going to be a free to Limerick. Quick word in his ear there by Fergal McCormack to Neil Ronan, his colleague. But what a catch that was by last year's Hurler of the Year, Brian Corcoran, from Aaron's own. The free is taken by Mark Foley. He's going for it, trying to drop it in, trying to drop it over, and he's done exactly that. First point for Mark Foley from Adair. That most beautiful spot in County Limerick. So now it's 1-7 to 6 points, and it's still anybody's match. 5 minutes to go to half-time. And what about this for a second wonderful catch in the space of about 3 minutes? Almost acrobatic stuff. Certainly balletic.
It shows you all that's great about hurling, doesn't it? A man had the courage to go up there and grab that ball.
I noticed that Mark Foley has gone in on Fergal McCormack in recent times. But right now, going through the Limerick defence or attempting to do so, is Joe Dean. Hand passed inside to his Ben O'Connor, Steve McDonough. What a wonderful player. Great experience there. McDonough's played in two All-Ireland finals, read the flight path excellently, and another brilliant catch. Three catches in the space of about 5 minutes by Brian Corcoran, fed out to Wayne Sherlock, trying to provide another score, and he's done exactly that. It's his first point. Doesn't score too many in the Cork colours. I think that might be his